Take a look again at these capillary tubes. Remember, capillary tubes are not distribution tubes. Here, this is a capillary tube system, all these little bitty tubes. These tubes, the size of these tubes and the length of these tubes, what's metering refrigerant. People ask all the time, well, how can you tell the difference between a capillary tube and a distribution tube? Well, here's a distribution tube, and notice it goes to this piece called a distributor, where it's sending refrigerant equally through these tubes. Ultimately, these tubes are a little bit larger than these tubes. You can see how these are brazed in, and this one has a fitted connection. Inside of this connection is our metering device, where in this case, this is our metering device. So there's a difference. Now, capillary tubes, you can buy these replacements, and they come in all different sizes. This one is a BC2. So the length and the size of this comes with the guide. It has the refrigerant you're working with and the horsepower of the compressor. If you're working with low temperature refrigerant, medium temperature, or high temperature refrigerants. High temperature is air conditioning. Medium temperature, you're looking at like food. Walk-ins, low temperature, you're looking at like freezers. So it tells us, let's say I had a R12 unit and it's a half horsepower. I would need, for low temperature, 96 inches of number 3 tubing. And if I had two different tubes, I would go over here to where it said a double feed. Or if we look over here, we have triple feed and also 4 feed and 5 feed, 6 feed. So here we can see this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one's a 6 feed tube. So here's 6 feed. Let's say we're using R409A and I have a 3 horsepower unit. I would need 105 inches of number 3 tubing if it was a walk-in freezer. Or if it was an air conditioner, I would need 75 inches of number 4 tubing. So it comes with this cool little chart. There's plenty of these charts out there on the internet. I've had tons of people asking me, hey, they got this system, can I help them size cap tubes? And the answer is no. I don't like cap tubes. I know that there's a good purpose for them, but if you don't know how to size cap tubes, go and look and do the research net yourself. I just don't enjoy doing it, and I don't have the time to do it. So here's a capillary tube for a refrigerator. There's our filter dryer here and our single cap tube. So the next thing people ask is, what does it look like inside? And that's a legitimate question, so let's cut this open and find out. So in this one, it's just a giant strainer. That's all it is. It's just a big giant screen. Looks like it's made of metal, and we can see, we're only looking at the outside, but we can see there's a pretty good bit of junk collected in there. Some pieces of copper, some trash. So this system was dirty, but the idea is it catches in the screen before it goes in through these little capillary tubes. Let's open this one up. You can see here, it's just a bunch of loose desiccant material, and there's a little filter inside of there. So that is our capillary tube. Now you're still gonna need return air wet bulb, outdoor dry bulb with a target superheat chart. These are going to be affected greatly by the conditions. As the outdoor temperature goes higher, we're gonna have less subcooling, we're gonna push more refrigerant through these tubes. And also the indoor temperature is gonna affect that as well. As the indoor temperature is higher, we're gonna boil away the refrigerant very, very quickly through here. If the indoor temperature is lower, we could essentially flood and have all of this evaporator full of refrigerant here, and it could even be flooded. There's no way of controlling or adjusting for its conditions. So also your humidity is gonna affect that. These are gonna change greatly with their load. However, a lot of the engineers prefer the capillary tube over a fixed orifice because it's considered what they call self-balancing. Now, I don't understand how it's self-balancing. I think maybe it has to do with the length of the tubing. It doesn't react as fast with conditions. I'm not 100% sure, but that's what I've been told. Don't take my word on that one. Look it up yourself. But that's capillary tube, fixed type metering device.